And we back with another episode of Doo-Wop. We see the Doo-Wop in the back. Let's get it. And we're finna make some Nashville hot chicken today. Chicken tenders, you know how I go. Finna open up this pack. Oh, and I got that Just Bear. Open up this pack. Wash this chicken off and we'll be back. All right, I washed the chicken off. Let's go ahead and sit my ass down like that. Got the onion powder. Throw that all up in there. Don't be scared. I got the chili powder. Throw that all in there. Don't be scared. I think this one gives it that little dark shit. Black pepper. Throw it in there, don't be scared. You got the garlic powder. Throw it in there. I even like this new ring light I got. If y'all wanna, if y'all need a ring light, go ahead and comment on my stuff. I got this big old $100 ring light for $54, actually for free. But you know, but got me meat tenderizer. They put that on all three sides. God, oh. I only put a little bit of that, cause that's the tenderizer. Oh, I forgot the salt in there. Hopefully I did, cause I'm about to put it in there. I'll go back and watch it if I forgot. Put this all in there. I should have put that in first. Alright. And put it in the, wrap it up and put it in the, refrigerator for an hour. And then we'll be back. Should have showed it to y'all before I put it in the. There you go. Now we're gonna put it in the refrigerator for an hour to marinate. Alright, and we back. Let's go ahead while we wait for the chicken tenders to marinate in the refrigerator. Let's go ahead and make the base, the wet base. So we start with 50 milligrams of flour. I don't know how much 50 milligrams, but we're going to just eye with our eyes. Some salt in that thing. I ain't bring the water. Some garlic powder. Some hot sauce. I'm gonna go get this water. I'll be right back. Alright, I'm back with the water. And we're gonna just put the water in until it. I know I need some more water. I'm gonna need some more water with that. I'm gonna need some more water. Okay. I put too much flour. Let's go get some more water. It's gonna be more base than I need. Alright, I'm back. Now, if this ain't enough water, I don't know what to tell them. Might have to do another base. Alright. There we go, but we gotta get it watery. Not watery, but you know, consistent like this. Y'all can see it. That's gonna be the base that we're gonna put the chicken tenders. All right, now let's go get the chicken tenders. They probably done. All right, I'm back with the chicken tenders. Let them marinate for an hour. I'd say probably an hour and 10 minutes. I'm gonna put some more hot sauce in there. This is, I want a Nashville hot chicken. Here go the flour. I think I need some more flour. Season with some garlic powder. Alright, let's get it. Mix that all around. Okay, now what we're gonna do is dip it in the so y'all can see it. Bring this over. I could have been more organized, but go ahead and work with me. Dunk this up in here. Get all the sides. Let that drain. Nothing in there. Going back for another dip. Well, I ain't gonna lie. Hopefully this. I should have bought peanut oil though. That's probably why I messed up on it. Alright, cover that thing up. It's the second drench. I'm getting flour everywhere. I just cleaned this tub. But get everything, because you don't want no naked chicken tender. You don't want no naked chicken tender, for sure. Transfer to your other plate. She just going to repeat the process. I'm finna change my glove and see how that's going. But we finna come back. Now that's just making a big ass mess. We gonna pour it up in the bowl. Alright. Get that out the way. Get that out the way. Yeah. I'm about to clean that little mess up, but get you some of my little salt up in there since you're pushing. Some little pepper up in there, and we're gonna get back. This is what I should have started. All right, I'm back to the drenching. All right, dip in the back. In the wet base first. Let that shit drip off. Use your other hand to put the flour on there, okay? Let's see, because I gotta try something else. Okay, I think that looks better. Gotta get every crevice. Alright, I think that looks better. Don't y'all? And easy. Go ahead. I grab it. Dunk it. Oh, we ain't double dunked that. Hold on. We ain't double dunked that one. Big Freddy boy. Hold on. Hey, that look like it's double dunked. I give it that. Alright, we're going. Back. Boy, now I know KFC and Popeyes and churches be doing it, huh? That thing quick. Ooh. Get every crevice though, don't miss it. And I learned you gotta add a heat medium high, not over high, because that's where it overcooks it. All right, I'll be back. Messy. And I'm on the last chicken tender. Put it in the sauce. I mean the water base. Put in the flour. This one, I'm not gonna put it in the water thing because I used it all. So we're just gonna do one dip. And we're gonna go to the hot grease with it. And one thing I did forget the egg. You were supposed to put the egg in that wet base. Yeah. Thought about it when I got the last tender. That's all good. Oh, let me put some on. Last tender. Now let's go to the hot grease. Alright, and we're back. And I said, hey, let's not go to the stove. Let's bring the stove to the stoop. Because I got the doo-wop on the back, you see. And I want to show y'all the concept. Alright, so you get you some oil, some fresh oil, and you put that in there. Ooh. Alright, that's. Now you want this to be medium hot, not hot, because you don't want to burn the chicken. Oh, some on the bottom. Oh, y'all hear that? That's something on the bottom of this. Let's see. Oh, we having technical difficulties. What the heck is that? Old pot. You see that smoking? Oh man. So now we're gonna have some technical difficulties. We'll see. We'll be back when it's hot. Medium hot. Remember, you don't want to burn your chicken. Alright, you gotta get the oil to 350 degrees. I use this thing. So you keep it in. Yeah.
Is your making
a
town stuff
off again? Let me take it out for right now. Ooh, that's hot. Alright. Now let's dump it in this oil. I'm gonna put two at a time. I'm gonna put this back in so I can. Oh shit, that shit hot.
If I take it out, that's what's
taking. Alright, it's 3 to 5 minutes on each side.
Who's this? Oh, yeah, my wild cock. Watch that hell. That shit ain't.
Hey, did you buy these pork chops or did I?
I did.
What?
And duck the other ones in. Wait 3 to 5 to 6 minutes. Alright, and we back. I didn't end up cutting them in half because them things were looking too big. I should have cut the rest off, but it's all good. Now, we're finna make the Nashville sauce. Let's get into it. We need some of this hot oil. Keep that stuff hot. Alright, let's start this Nashville sauce. You need some cayenne pepper. I don't know how much, just put as much as you need. Let me put some with something. Garlic powder. And Caesar salt. You need black What the fuck is it called? Brown, dark, brown sugar, but we ain't got that. I'm finna go see if we got light, though. All right, we got light. Now let me go get this hot oil and I'll be back. Alright, then we back. Now we're gonna put this hot oil inside the that's the hot almost get started. I got pop. Now we're gonna put this hot oil inside this this season. Oh shit. Oh, that do look like it though.
Now you just know that shit can probably help.
Is it mixing up real good? I don't know. I'm gonna dip the chicken in there and see. Probably gotta put some more seasoning in there. That thing don't look Nashville to you, does it? It doesn't to me either. Hold on, let's retry this thing. Alright, fuck it. I'ma give y'all an honest review on it. That's what it looked like. I did one. I ain't wanna mess up the other ones. We're gonna see. Almost has that Nashville.